Valley Auto Sales. For affordable, reliable vehicles, call 1-505-249-7134 or visit online at www.valleyautosales.com.
Pretty consistent in the gym, so I'm always pretty fairly ready. So, yeah.
In terms of Renato, he's also probably never been more popular, you know, cutting his money with Moicano promos and everything. So, what do you make of him as an opponent?
He's another opponent. That's what it is at the end of the day.
Last two for me. Can I get your thoughts on the main event between Alex and Jamal and the BMF fight between Justin and Max?
Well, they're going to be spectacular fights. They're definitely going to be stand up battles. Best man is
going to
win both those fights.
Hey, Jalin, over here. How's it going? I remember when we spoke ahead of this fight, you were talking about how people don't give enough credit for your striking. Do you feel like this is the exact type of matchup that could really showcase that and remind people just with the fact that you have knockout power, you've seen Moicano get knocked out a few times. I feel like this is a good opportunity, especially in this big card. Absolutely. Well, your ground game is pretty, you know, obviously well established as well. Like, if it does go to the ground, how comfortable do you feel about that?
I feel pretty comfortable getting up, and, you know, especially defense feels really on par. I started training jiu-jitsu and the gi again, so I feel good. Everything kind of aligned, you know, so, yeah, I'm ready. Well versed for this moment.
What about the implications of a victory? Jose just mentioned, you know, how popular Moicano is. Obviously, it's a huge card as well. Is this the type of fight that really gets you, you know, a notable opponent after this? And, seems like the UFC, you know, likes you putting on this card.
Yeah, you know, I would like that, you know, but also in the grand scheme of things, like I have no say, you know, like I do want to go in there and perform and get a spectacular win, and at the end of the day, you know, I've got to just figure out what happens after that. That's it.
Just last one for me, any fight week rituals, like doing all things to just keep your mind off fighting and all this stuff, is there anything you like doing while you're in Vegas?
State of them all. So when you got your fight put together as the last one, what did you make of Renato being the guy that you're going to share the cage with for this big occasion?
Yeah, it was cool. I mean, you know, he said my name a couple times, so we tried to make it happen. I don't know why it didn't work out. You know, this time it worked out, so I'll get to see him on the other side of the octagon Saturday night.
How did it feel fighting in Austin compared to fighting at the T-Mobile so many times every week?
Austin was actually pretty lit. Like, it was cool. It was a cool atmosphere. It was different. Like, the whole process was different. It was like a cool little refreshment. You know, I felt like I was like a hungry young fighter again, like fighting somewhere else. Like, it felt good.
A lot of talk about this card as the bonus, potential bonus, but it's gonna be hard to get one given how many fights and amazing fighters on this card. So how are you gonna separate yourself from the rest of the card in order to score a big bonus potential?
You know, I got a couple things up my sleeve, and I gotta see if my
given the way you fight and how to fight, you think that's a big possibility of getting the fight of the night?
Jalin right here. Jalin, was wondering, you just recently did the Jackson podcast. Just wondering, how was that experience recording with those guys?
That's cool. You know, they're my sponsors, so they're cool.
And then, obviously, you've been part of so many big cards, but like 300, does it feel like, hey, it won't get bigger than this one? Or do you feel like, hey, after being part of so many pay-per-views, T-Mobile, all this, it's like, you know what? I do think it could still get even bigger.
The biggest card would be a part of the one that I get to headline.
Jalin, here in the back. You fought many different styles in the UFC so far. Do you feel like Moicano's is reminiscent to anybody you've already taken on?
Yeah, he kind of reminds me of Callum Potter. No, just because like Tom Hart was a black belt also, and yeah, I don't know why. Those are the only two that correlate to me. I'm pretty sure there's other people that I've fought that have like the same accolades. Like I don't know how durable he is. Dan Hooker was definitely the toughest fighter I've ever fought in my life. I don't know if Moicano is that durable. So you know, I won't know until I fight him. But yeah, you know, body wise, you know, styles kind of similar to.
Thank you.
Hey, Jalin, what's it going to take for the UFC to put on like a skateboarding competition? There's a couple of skateboarders in the promotion, and we all know that she loves to get down.
Man, yeah, we definitely need to do that. That could be a cool little spinoff. They could make some money doing that. You know, little game of skate, you know, have the Barons sponsor it or set it up, you know what I mean? I definitely think I could win that.
Thank you.
You've been doing it.